It may not come as a big surprise. According to a recent survey, inflation and not having enough money for retirement is one of Americans' top concerns. The Thrivent Financial Survey found 93% worry about inflation and the effect that it's having on their retirement. Tim Gaylor from Thrivent Financial is here to tell how to ease those concerns and to talk about this survey. Great to have you here today.
Great to be here. You know, what's interesting about that survey is over 50% of people actually think about it all the time.
Did that surprise you?
It really does. We think about this, and I think what's happening is people are realizing that they need to have a plan, but they understand they're living longer in retirement as well. And the longer you live, the greater impact inflation can really eat away at your standard of living.
Do you suspect that all this talk and hyper-focus by media on the deficit and those kinds of discussions are kind of subtly eating away at people's confidence?
Absolutely. Well, yes, because with the debt, with the economy that went down, with where America stands right now, we think that actually led a lot to how the survey played out, mm-hmm. which is frankly a good thing for our financial industry because we need to help people get to retirement and live in retirement the way they want to live.
Part of your mission is to help people get there, obviously, and to allay some of those concerns. We're coming off, as you pointed out, this very fear-fraught time. It's time to get real, though,
right.
And you can't begin too soon. There's some things that you talk about here that we're going to discuss right now. A balanced portfolio. We hear that a lot.
Absolutely. You know, balanced portfolio, if you're pre-50, you know what? All inflation says is you might actually have to be saving more money than you initially thought. Balanced portfolio, when you get to retirement, what we mean by that is, you know what? There are certain financial products like an annuity, for instance, that can give you a guaranteed stream of income to go along with your balanced portfolio. As your balanced portfolio goes up in a positive economy, you can actually take a little bit of income off that and feed that into your guaranteed income stream.
You suggest always monitoring your retirement, but not becoming obsessive about that.
I have some friends that look at it daily.
Which is not a good idea,
no,
really.
You probably drive it into the grave a little faster.
Sure. Well, you don't want to do that.
No. You want to monitor your assets and understand where you're at, how you live, and how you don't live.
Okay, I'm 25 years old, let's say. I should start saving.
You should start saving, and what we recommend, frankly, some people like to do it by themselves, but a financial professional can help you get to that inflation area. Is 4% enough? Is 6% to save enough? You know what? It might not be. If you're going to not retire for 40 years, imagine how much a loaf of bread cost 40 years ago.
For sure. Spending. Watch your spending, especially as you get closer to retirement.
As you get closer to retirement, correct. You want to look at what you have compared to what you need. You know what? Not everybody has the ability to just write a check for anything they want.
Creating a retirement income plan. You mentioned annuities. That's mm-hmm. one instrument that you
correct.
Can do. But there are a lot of different ways
absolutely.
To get there.
Mutual funds are great ways. Financial professionals have different ways. As this inflation becomes more concerning to the financial industry, you're going to see other evolving products develop.
Part of your survey, too, as we say goodbye to you, is that most of us recognize we're going to have to work longer than we anticipated.
I believe that is the case. The average person maybe thought they were going to live till they're 60 or retire when they're 60. You're right. Because of inflation, because of that eating away, people might have to look and reexamine. Is 65 it? Is 70 it?
Mm-hmm.
And again, that's something that you need to monitor that yourself, almost just like you're monitoring your retirement account.
I'd like to be able to work as long as I choose, not because I have to.
That's true.
Who
that's
knows
true.
How that'll shake down.
Great.
Once again, Tim Gaylor, to have you here today from Thrivent Financial. For more tips and more information, go on to Carol 11 News. Look under the Money tab there.